I welcome you all to my YouTube channel Insight into Chemical Engineering. In this lecture series, we will solve the unsolved problem of a famous book, Stoichiometry and Process Calculations by Kevin Arrhenius. These lectures are helpful for chemical engineering students because process calculation is a core subject for chemical engineering branch. So during lecture, step by step solution will be provided. And in this lecture, exercise number 4.55 to 4.57 will be covered. Please like and subscribe for motivation. Problem number 4.55. Pure sulfur is burned with excess air to give sulfur trioxide, and due to incomplete oxidation, some sulfur dioxide is also formed. It means there are two type of reactions. One is desired and one is undesired. The analysis of the burner gases showed certain percentage of SO3, SO2, O2 and nitrogen. So find out the percent excess air supplied and the volume of burner gases at particular temperature and pressure conditions. So in this problem, the composition of burner gases are given. So what we can do, we can assume the total moles of burner gases so that moles of SO3, SO2, O2 and N2 in the living gas will become known. Then we can do the back calculations and we can find out corresponding to these moles what were the required amount of sulfur and oxygen. Now we are assuming total moles of burner gases equal to 100 mole. So we can write moles of SO3 produced equal to 0.8 and moles of SO2 produced equal to 7.8 and moles of O2 unreacted equal to 12.2, because this O2 gas is coming out in the living gases. It means it is unburned O2. And amount of inert equal to 79.2, and it will remain same before and after reaction. So as per problem, it is given that sulfur is burned with excess air to give sulfur trioxide. So find the amount of pure sulfur supplied, then accordingly estimate the amount of air required. Means we have already assumed the total moles of burner gases equal to 100 mole, and moles of gases leaving are known. So we have to write the balanced chemical reaction and then we can do the back calculation. So first we will write the desired reaction. So sulfur is combining with oxygen and it is giving SO3, and there is undesired reaction. So in undesired reaction, sulfur is combining it with oxygen and giving SO2. Now we know that what is the amount of SO3 produced. So amount of SO3 produced is 0.8 mole. So corresponding to these moles of SO3, we can find out the moles of sulfur supplied. So for 1 mole of SO3 produced, moles of sulfur required equal to 1 mole. So in the same way, for 0.8 mole of SO3 produced, moles of sulfur required will be 0.8. So we have done a back calculations, and accordingly we can write the amount of oxygen required. So in the same way, we can write for undesired chemical reaction. So for undesired chemical reaction, amount of SO2 produced is 7.8. So in the same way, we can find out the amount of sulfur required corresponding to undesired amount of SO2. Now we can write the moles of sulfur supplied equal to 0.8, which is coming from desired reaction, plus 7.8 from undesired reaction. So moles of oxygen reacted will be equal to 1.2 from the desired reaction and 7.8 from the undesired reaction. So it will become equal to 9 mole. Now we can write total oxygen supplied equal to oxygen reacted. So this is the amount of oxygen that got reacted, and already there is unreacted amount of oxygen in the living gases. So total oxygen supplied will become equal to reacted oxygen plus unreacted oxygen. So it will become equal to 21.2 mole. Now we need to find the theoretically required amount of oxygen as per desired reaction. Now as per desired reaction, so 1 mole of sulfur requires 3/2 moles of oxygen. Therefore 8.6 moles of sulfur, because the sulfur supplied equal to 8.6. So corresponding to 8.6 mole of sulfur, what is the theoretically required amount of oxygen? So theoretically required oxygen will be equal to 12.9 mole of O2, because we have to find the percentage excess air supplied, and we have already estimated the total oxygen supplied. So total oxygen supplied is 21.2 mole, and theoretically required amount of oxygen is 12.9. So if we will take the difference, then we will get the excess amount of oxygen supplied. So in part A, we need to find the percentage excess air supplied. So first we will write the formula for percentage excess. So it will be equal to excess amount divided by theoretically required amount into 100. So in the previous slide, we have already estimated the total amount of oxygen and theoretically required amount of oxygen. So simply we will put the values. So here it is asked about excess air, but if we will take the same number of moles of oxygen, we will get the same results. Here there is no need to convert the moles of oxygen to moles of air and then finding out the same percentage excess. So if we will do with the same amount of oxygen, we will get the same result. So here simply we have put the amount of oxygen supplied minus theoretically required amount of oxygen, and it will come out as 64.34%. So in part B, we need to find the volume of burner gases at 1.2 bar and 300 Kelvin per 1 kg sulfur burned. So in the previous case, we have assumed that the total moles of burner gas was equal to 100 moles, and corresponding to that, we have estimated the amount of sulfur. But here, amount of sulfur is already given. So first we will find out the number of moles of sulfur. So moles of sulfur will be equal to weight of sulfur, that is 1000 gram, divided by its molecular weight. So it will come out as 31.25 mole. So we have already estimated the moles of sulfur supplied, that was equal to 8.5 mole per 100 moles of burner gases, because in the previous case we have assumed total moles of burner gases equal to 100, and corresponding to 100 we have estimated the moles of sulfur supplied. So using the same relation, we can find out the moles of burner gases corresponding to 31.25 mole of sulfur. So we will write 8.6 mole of sulfur produces 100 mole of burner gases. So 1 mole of sulfur will produce less, so it will become equal to 100 divided by 8.6, and we need to find corresponding to 31.25. So corresponding to these, we will get 3.37 mole. Now we need to find the volume of burner gases, because we have estimated the total moles of burner gases. So we can use the ideal gas equation, because already the pressure and temperature are given. So after putting all values, we will get 15.11 meter cube. Now in part C, we need to find the volume of air supplied at particular pressure and temperature per kg sulfur burn. Now we will use the same relation, and we will write for 8.6 mole of sulfur, O2 supplied is 21.2 mole. So in the previous slide, we have already estimated the moles of sulfur and moles of O2 supplied corresponding to 100 moles of burner gases. So moles of O2 supplied was equal to 21.2 mole. Now corresponding to 1 mole of sulfur, it will become equal to 21.86, and we need to find the amount of O2 supplied corresponding to 31.25 mole of sulfur. So corresponding to 31.25, it will become equal to 77.03 moles. Now we can write that 21% of air will give the amount of oxygen, which is equal to 77.03 mole. So we can find out the air supplied. So air supplied will become equal to 366.86 mole. Now we can find out the volume of air using ideal gas equation. Because number of moles are known and already pressure and temperature are given. So it will come out as 8.67 meter cube. Problem number 4.56. An organic ester is to be hydrogenated at a rate of 100 kg per hour to yield C19H38O2. So the hydrogen required for the plant which runs continuously is available at 50 liter cylinder in which the gas is contained at 70 bar and 300 Kelvin. Find how many cylinders the company should order per week. So we have to find the number of cylinders which are required per week. So already the volume of one cylinder and corresponding to this temperature and pressure are given. So using ideal gas equation, we can find out the moles of gases in one cylinder. Now we have to find out what is the total moles of H2 required. Then we can find out the total cylinders required per week. So we will take basis as 1 hour, because it is given that ester is hydrogenated at a rate of 100 kg per hour. So we will do the calculations per hour. Write the balanced chemical reaction, and we can write the molecular weight of ester, so it will come out as 296 gram per mole. So we can write moles of ester will be equal to weight of ester divided by its molecular weight. So it will come out as 337.84 mole. Now from this equation we can write 1 mole of ester requires 1 mole of hydrogen. So this much mole of ester will require the same moles of H2. Now it is given that we need to find the cylinders per week. So first estimate hours in 1 week. So in 1 week, 1 into 7 into 24, which will be equal to 168 hour. So H2 required per week will become equal to 337.84 into 168 hour, because we have assumed the basis equal to 1 hour. So corresponding to 1 hour, the amount of O2 required is 337.84. So the available hours are 1.68. So H2 required per week will become equal to this much. Now we can find out the moles of hydrogen present in one cylinder, because already it is given that 50 liter cylinder in which gas is contained at 70 bar and 300 Kelvin. So using ideal gas equation, we can write N equal to PV by RT. So number of moles of hydrogen present in one cylinder equal to 140.33, and total moles of hydrogen required पर वीक इक्वल टू 5677.12। सिंपली इफ यू विल डिवाइड द टोटल रिक्वायर्ड मोल डिवाइडेड बाय मोल्स ऑफ H2 प्रेजेंट इन वन सिलेंडर, सो नंबर ऑफ सिलेंडर रिक्वायर्ड विल बी इक्वल टू टोटल मोल्स ऑफ H2 रिक्वायर्ड पर वीक डिवाइडेड बाय मोल्स ऑफ H2 प्रेजेंट इन वन सिलेंडर, सो ओवरऑल 404.45 सिलेंडर विल बी रिक्वायर्ड, सो वी कैन टेक इट एज 405 सिलेंडर। प्रॉब्लम नंबर 4.57, फॉर्मल्डिहाइड इज प्रोड्यूस्ड by the gas phase oxidation of methanol with air over catalyst. 100 meter cube of methanol vapor at particular pressure and temperature is to be treated. If 10% excess air is supplied and reaction is only 80% complete, calculate the composition of the product gas. So it is given that certain volume of methanol is present at particular temperature and pressure. So first of all, we can find out the total moles of CH3OH using ideal gas equation. Then it is given that 10% excess air is supplied, then we need to estimate the total air supplied. So once we have estimated the amount of CH3OH and the moles of O2 supplied, then we will use this condition that the reaction is 80% complete. And then we will find out the composition of the product gas. So as per problem, CH3OH is available at 100 meter cube and 1.013 × 10⁵ Pascal and 550 Kelvin. So using ideal gas law, we can find out the moles of CH3OH supplied. So after putting all values, we will get 2.215 kmol. So we can write from this equation, 1 mole of CH3OH requires half mole of O2. So corresponding to 2.215 kmol of CH3OH, we can find out the required mole of oxygen. So required mole of oxygen will become equal to 1.108 kmol. So as per problem, 10% excess air is supplied. So oxygen excess will be equal to 10% of required oxygen. So O2 excess will become equal to 0.11 kmol. Now we can write oxygen supplied equal to oxygen required, which is equal to 1.108 plus oxygen excess. So this is the excess amount. So total oxygen supplied will become equal to 1.219 kmol. Now corresponding to these moles, we can find out the amount of air. So air, 21% of air will be equal to oxygen supplied. So from this we can find out the air supplied. So air supplied will be equal to 5.805 kmol. Now we can find out the moles of nitrogen. So moles of nitrogen, because N2 will act as inert and it will remain same before and after reaction. So amount of N2 will be equal to 79% of air supplied. So 79% of 5.805 will be equal to 4.586 kmol. So in part A, we need to find the composition of the product gas. And also it is given that reaction is only 80% complete. So first we will write the moles of CH3OH reacted. So it will be equal to 80% of supplied moles. And in the previous slide we have already estimated the moles of CH3OH supplied. So 1.772 kilomoles will be the moles of CH3OH reacted. So unreacted moles will become equal to 20% of supplied. So it will come out as 0.443 kilomole. Now write the balanced chemical reaction, and we know what is the amount of CH3OH reacted. So that is 1.772. So corresponding to that, we can find out the amount of oxygen reacted. So amount of oxygen reacted will be equal to half of CH3OH reacted. So amount of unreacted O2 will be equal to total oxygen supplied that we have already estimated in the previous slide minus amount of oxygen reacted, that is 0.886 kmol. So it will come out as 0.333 kmol. So we can write the amount of HCHO produced equal to 1.772 kmol, because as per stoichiometric equation, 1 mole of CH3OH will give 1 mole of HCHO, and reacted amount of CH3OH is 1.772. So the amount of HCHO produced will be equal to 1.772. So in the same way, we can write the amount of H2O produced. Now we can write total moles of product gases will be equal to unreacted amount of CH3OH and unreacted amount of oxygen and produced amount of HCHO and produced amount of H2O plus amount of inerts. So total moles of product gas will be equal to unreacted amount of CH3OH plus unreacted oxygen plus inerts O2 plus produced HCHO plus produced H2O. So after putting all values, we will get total moles of product gas equal to 8.906 kmol. Now we can write mole percentage of unreacted CH3OH in the product gas will be equal to moles of unreacted CH3OH, that is 0.443, divided by total moles of product gas, which is equal to 8.906. So moles of unreacted CH3OH that is the mole percentage, it will come out as 4.97%. Now in the same way, we can find out the mole percentage of unreacted oxygen. So it will be equal to the amount of oxygen present in the living gas divided by total moles of product gas into 100. So in the same way, mole percentage of inerts N2 can be estimated, and mole percentage of HCHO or H2O, because in the reactions the moles of HCHO and H2O are same, so the mole percentage will come out same, that is 19.9%. So in part B, we need to find the volume of product gases at particular pressure and temperature. So we have already estimated the total moles of product gas. So using ideal gas, we can find out the volume. So total moles of product gas equal to 8.906 kmol. So using ideal gas equation, we can estimate the volume. So after putting all values, we will get 394.9 m³.